Hi, Dr. Charles Chabert, urologist and director of the Prostate Clinic. The following video is for those people who are awaiting or have interest in the information regarding a robotic simple prostatectomy. So the aim really is to prepare you for this surgery and to let you know what you can expect if you've had this operation. So beforehand, to summarize really, a robotic simple prostatectomy is a type of keyhole surgery that we use to treat men who have significant urinary symptoms that are related to a significantly enlarged prostate. As you may be aware from previous discussions with your urologist, there are several treatment choices available to treat urinary symptoms related to a big prostate. But if you have a truly enormous prostate or massive BPH, BPH is the benign prostatic hyperplasia, if you have a truly enormous prostate, one of the most efficient ways to remove the bulk of the obstructing prostate tissue is with enucleation, and this can be done via a robotic approach. So before we get to surgery, most people will attend the pre-admission clinic. They may have some blood work done, a tracing of their heart, and a urine test to make sure that there is no sign of urinary infection before we proceed on. The surgery is performed under a general anesthetic, so you are asleep during that time, and an additional spinal anesthetic is used as well, which is a small injection into the lower part of the back, and what that does is to keep you very comfortable when you wake up from your procedure. The procedure itself is done at Pindara Private Hospital here in Benoa. When you arrive in the hospital, you will present to the admissions desk. And before you come to hospital, you'll have some advice from your anaesthetist about the last time that you can eat or drink prior to your surgery, but usually this is around 6 hours before your surgery. At the pre-admission clinic, they will make an assessment of your background and current health issues, including different medications that you may or may not use. It's really important at this stage for you to highlight to us if you're taking any blood thinners, which can include anything from aspirin or Plavix, all the way through to Xarelto or Eliquis. So please let us know, and then we can give you a tailored approach as to whether or not you need to stop this medication before we proceed on with your surgery. As indicated, a combination of a general anesthetic and a spinal anesthetic is used, and we have found over the years that a combination of these two facilitates the surgery but keeps you really comfortable in the post-operative period. When you wake up from the operation, you will have a catheter in place, which is a plastic tube that comes through the penis and into the bladder, and it allows your bladder to drain after the surgery. Sometimes we will wash out the catheter if there is any debris or small amounts of bleeding from the surgical site. This can just be gently washed away. If that is the case, we usually leave the washings going through the night and take everything down the next day. There are dissolvable stitches in the wound, and you'll notice a slight purple covering over each of the small incisions in your tummy. This is skin glue, and it keeps the wounds waterproof afterwards and just means that you can have a shower the next day after your surgery and you just pat the wounds dry. For the majority of people after this surgery, they are discharged on the day after their operation. It's important to note that you are discharged with your catheter in place. A bag is applied onto the end of the catheter, and you're provided with some education about how to manage that bag over the following week. So people are discharged with a bag, you keep the bag for a week. There is a leg bag that attaches onto the thigh, and you will be given a night bag, which is a larger bag with connecting tubing, which at nighttime you plug into the day bag. You do not remove the day bag from the catheter. That's an important point to note. If you do remove the day bag from the catheter, we're increasing the potential for infection to travel through the catheter and into the bladder. And obviously that's something that we don't want to happen. So to recap, you'll have a catheter that comes out through the penis. It will be connected through to a leg bag. And at nighttime, before you go to sleep, you will attach it through to a larger bag, a nighttime bag. And really what this does is it allows urine to flow from the bladder through into the first bag and then to collect into the second bag. It means really that you can have a better night's sleep as things will passively drain and fill up the larger bag through the evening rather than needing to change the smaller capacity bag through the night. Many men report to me that they're quite surprised at actually how much urine they produce, particularly in the first few days. And the reason for that is that you're given quite a bit of fluid through the drip during your hospital stay. And when your body starts to recover, that fluid is then mobilized back into the vascular tree and your kidneys start to produce more urine. The keys to a quick recovery after this surgery are to make sure that you do stay really well hydrated in that first week, so drink plenty of fluid. I like patients to walk gently on the flat, really as much as they can tolerate in that first week. So I encourage everyone in the first day after your operation, I'd like you to walk a minimum of 0.5 kilometer, and then from day two until we remove the catheter, a minimum of 1 kilometer. At 7 days following your operation, you come back to hospital. At that stage, we send off a urine test. It is very common at that time to find that there can be bugs that grow on the catheter. It does not mean that you have a urinary tract infection. It just means that the catheter itself is colonized with a bug, and the process of removing the catheter and giving you a single dose of antibiotic, usually as a tablet, at that time is sufficient to make sure that you don't develop an infection after removal of the catheter. So the catheter is removed, and at that point we go through a process which is called a trial avoid, which in essence basically means that we assess your ability to pee and empty your bladder. We get you to perform 3 sequential pees. You pee in the bottle, the team will measure how much you actually pee, and then we do a small bedside ultrasound to make sure that you're not retaining excessive amounts of urine. As long as you give us 3 ticks in the box, we are happy for you to be discharged from hospital that day. Be prepared. That process can take, sometimes if it's quick, 3 or 4 hours, but be prepared to spend 1/2 a day through to maybe 6 hours in the hospital just whilst we make sure that everything is okay. I will have the pathology available and will either call you with the results of the pathology, or that pathology will be made available to you at the time that we remove the catheter. I see everyone back in the office again 12 weeks after your surgery, and the aim of that visit is to make sure that your urinary function, number one, has improved. So we get you to fill out another questionnaire that you will have filled out prior to your surgery, and so we can compare the two and see where things have improved. In addition to that, we will require you to do a flow test. So on that occasion, please arrive with a full bladder. Arrive with a full bladder, we'll check your flow, and we'll make sure that there is a significant improvement, which for just about every man there is at that time. If there are any questions at that point, we'll address them. And then usually moving forward, the plan is for you to have a PSA, the blood test for the health of the prostate, which we'll do on an annual basis. And that can be done either with your GP locally, or it can be done through the prostate clinic, and we'll make that call at that time. I hope this answers your questions. If, however, you do have additional questions, please leave them in the comment box below, or alternatively, if you're awaiting prostate surgery with me and you'd like to ask a question more immediately, please call through to our office, leave the question with the staff, and I'll ensure I get an answer back to you. Hope this helps.